Hey, look, what's that?
It appears Jack has found a plant worth viewing. Jack, why don't you take us?
And before we have, it's Jack Doyle, ready to embark on the greatest trip ever.
The Jack Doyle is a natural-born predator.
Look at him in his natural habitat.
A mark from a fight with another male over a female.
Natural selection at its finest.
Deserts are regions that receive less than 10 inches of water per year. They cover about one-third of the Earth's land surface. In harsh desert environments, plants have two major ways to survive drought. After a rainstorm, desert plants, known as succulents, collect and store water in their fleshy stems, leaves, or roots. Some desert plants also grow very rapidly after a rainstorm, completing their entire life cycle in a few weeks.
Rowan, so what is your name?
Ray Jorgensen.
And you work at Garfield Park, obviously?
Yeah,
Garfield
Park Conservatory.
How long have you been working here?
It'll be 11 years, Cinco de Mayo.
Wow. What are your responsibilities here, taking care of the plants?
Primarily, I take care of the desert house. We all help set shows and stuff. Those are the houses that change periodically. And then we have outside responsibilities, too. I take care of the bluestone, which is right outside the door there.
Get a load of the Nick Badoo.
There's just so many wonderful plants.
You know anything interesting about any of the plants around us?
Well, there's a lot of interesting things. I don't know if you see that really tall mast up there that's poking into the glass. It actually got cut. It went up about 8 feet out of the window. It's an agave inflorescence, there's tons of inflorescences on it. Well, no, that's pectorine inflorescence. There were tons of flowers, and now actually all those things you see up there, if you can zoom in on them, I don't know if you can get much of a shot, but those are little plantlets. They're referred to as bulbils, and, you know, there's maybe 1,000 something on there, and they have the ability to fall and all of them grow into another plant. There's actually one that's planted near it to the past us, you know, to the north.
Wow.
That's like 3 or 4 years old. That one's probably like 45 years old or something.
Wow.
But it just flowers once and then dies.
Wow.
So we had to close the window, so we had to cut it off at the top of the window when it got too cold. Well, there's a lot of cool plants. There's the Welwitschia, which you might want to check out over there. It's in its own family and own genus. Sometimes people think of it as sort of a, what do they refer to it as? Like a link plant between different genera or different families. There's nothing else like it, like a ephedra is sort of similar. It's a missing link maybe between flowering plants and gymnosperms.
Mm-hmm.
But it's from the Namib Desert in southwest Africa. And it can go for years with actually no measurable rain. It survives pretty much on fog. It only grows near the coast. So you have the cold Atlantic air mass hitting the hot land mass. And then you get fog daily. So that's what it survives on. It kind of looks like this guy, which is also South Africa, in that its leaves are wide and narrow. And most desert plants aren't like that. This actually doesn't grow into true desert. A lot of these plants don't. But most things are reduced, you know, maybe even to a round ball or something. But the Welwitschia, it actually also, I should mention, it grows to like 2,000 years old, the carbon date that aren't things. But it has these really wide, grass-like leaves that just grow and grow and grow. Two leaves, most leaves are finite growth. These are undetermined. They just keep growing and growing. It just has two leaves that grow forever, well, at least 2,000 years. And it's got this huge surface area, which in most deserts would just fry it because it would lose too much water. But this actually is adapted to gather the water, you know, from the condensation from the dew.
Wow.
So it works out pretty
well. My name's Zach Allen. I like to party.
So here we have the Stock plant. It was founded by my great-grandfather, Bennington Stock.
This room is too humid for my liking.
Natalie, what'd you learn today?
I learned that agave and aloe had some conversion evolution going on.
Well, you actually learned something?
Jack taught me that, so that's about it.
Yeah, he did. Oh, hey, Mr. Madden. Look at that smile. What a babe.
You know any interesting things about the plants around us, or just any plant in general?
That something I like?
Yeah.
The interesting thing is probably that geranium. You can just touch it, feel that, and smell it.
This one right here?
The next one. The other side. Yeah, just feel it.
Oh, yeah.
And then smell it. Smell your hand.
That's a synthesis.
Ooh, that is nice.
I know, isn't that good?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Thanks a lot.
Yeah, thanks for your time.
Thank you very much. Hey, George, what'd you learn today?
I learned today that moss helps soil and also
water absorption.
We have the Swiss cheese plant.
Monstera obliqua.
As you may see, it looks a bit like Swiss cheese, just like mommy used to make.
It's got holes in the plant leaves.
And look at that.
It looks like a bird defecated on this leaf.
That could have been Blaze, Natalie, or any other bird.
And right here we got some interesting flower. This isn't even a leaf. I don't know what this is.
Quill. Brian, what can you tell us that you learned today?
I learned that flowers are fun.
Do you actually like plants?
I don't want you to say it is. I've been lying.
Mr. Madden, what have you learned today?
I learned a heck of a lot. Learned a few new plant names. Learned about Seminole bread, which is my favorite plant in this section. There it is right there. Zamia.
Can you tell us what you've learned today?
Oh man, it's so much.
So much?
So much. I learned about azaleas. Apparently they have two things that are very unique, but I haven't figured out what that is yet.
All right. Emma, do you like plants?
Oh man, I love plants.
That's too bad. All right, thank you.
You test all over again.
Together.
Everything.
Supposed to tell us.